Hello friends, here in this video we will see what is the meaning of SN curve. So let us get started. SN curve, also called as fatigue curve. Now SN curve, it is a graph between stress and number of cycles plotted for fatigue loading. So it is a graph between stress and number of cycles and plotted for fatigue loading. Here fatigue failure is considered. It means a material is subjected to alternate tensile and compressive stresses at the same time. So the material is subjected to tensile and compressive stresses at the same time. That is the meaning of fatigue stresses, and the results of the fatigue testing plotted on a graph is called as SN curve. So the results of the fatigue testing which is plotted on the graph is called as SN curve. And now I'll draw that SN curve to explain it in a more effective manner. So now here we have a graph in which on y-axis we have bending stresses starting from 0, then 100, 200, 300, 400. It is in terms of Newton per mm square. Similarly on x-axis we have number of cycles of failure, that is the object is subjected to 10 raised to 5 cycles, that is that much amount of time the stresses are acting on that object. So here we have number of cycles. Now I'll plot for two different materials. The first one is mild steel. This line which I have drawn, this indicates mild steel, which is also a ferrous metal. Next, this constant line is called as fatigue limit. Then, after that, we have one non-ferrous metal. This I can say that it is aluminium, which is a non-ferrous metal. Now see, in SN curve it is very much understood that for mild steel, if we are operating at a higher amount of stress, then it will last for less amount of cycles, that is the number of cycles of failure are less. Then if we go on decreasing the stress for mild steel, there comes a point where after reaching a certain number of cycles, that is between 10^6 and 10^7, after that it is constant, that is the fatigue limit is constant. It means the material, when it has reached a particular state of a stress, then it can go for infinite number of cycles. So that is for ferrous metals. But for non-ferrous metals, if it is operating at less number of cycles and less number of stress, then if we, along with the stress, if we go on decreasing the stress but increasing the number of cycles, that is, this non-ferrous metals, they can operate at less amount of stress for more number of cycles. So I can say that from this figure which I have drawn, this is the SN curve, and I can say that ferrous metals can operate at high stresses for less number of cycles, whereas non-ferrous metals can operate at less amount of stresses for more number of cycles. So your ferrous metals, they can operate at high stresses for less number of cycles. Then after a certain stage, the stress remains constant and then it can operate for infinite cycles. Whereas for non-ferrous metals, they operate at less stress, and if we go on decreasing the stress, they can operate at a very huge number of cycles. So the number of cycles of failure increases for non-ferrous metals. So in this video, we have seen the SN curve.